The thing is, lifting your chin just a little bit is a more appealing position for the face, not this much, but it's a very nice position for the face because it helps define the jawline and creates a slimming effect for the neck region. Charm is the alluring side of charisma. It's actually the most important side. It is the constituent that draws people in and projects a more confident and attractive image of your persona. You need to learn some of the ways that charming men use when they want to improve. And no matter what you may hear, charm is a trait that all of us have. But the secret is to unlock and harness its power and use it as a foundation for developing your winning personality. Now, I know we have all seen charming people and they seem to effortlessly work a room while others admire and compliment them. So what are the best strategies that can help you better display your charming personality? Alright, so at number one, we have great posture. It's really important to know that all charming individuals have great posture, and that means a lot of different things in terms of nonverbal language. And I know my posture is probably better now that I'm talking about it, so. Charming men always find a good posture regardless of whether they're standing, sitting, or walking. And that has to do with a very important aspect, the way they move their chin. Now, we all know that keeping your head up is a sign of confidence, and the way you present your jawline is seen as a sign of masculinity, and it has always been one. The key is knowing when to lift your chin during decisive points of the conversation and when to lower it during the working our way up to conclusion phase. The thing is, lifting your chin just a little bit is a more appealing position for the face, not this much, but it's a very nice position for the face because it helps define the jawline and creates a slimming effect for the neck region. So number two, learn to bond. Charming men cultivate their charm no matter where they find themselves. This is probably the number one factor in gaining people's trust and ensuring that they are well thought of. Take very popular actors like George Clooney, for example. This man is almost universally liked for a reason. He tries to mimic the behavior of people he interacts with. And he does that with everyone from journalists to co-stars. He smiles when you smile. And he frowns when you frown. He always shows he's genuinely glad to meet you, and that is very important. People will always respond well to a person that seems to have their undivided attention. And charming means to treat everyone the same way, with a lot of respect and kindness. Number three, charming men are never alone. You have to know that your charm finds its strength in your ability to communicate and interact with people. The same way a lead singer cannot perform properly without his band, you will not be able to exercise your charm on a collective level if you're not surrounded by the right people. Charm works better when your magnetism is augmented by more than one listener. People tend to look more attractive and charming when in groups, because it shows off their great communication skills and makes you look as instinctive and charismatic as possible. Now, to achieve this, always try to agree rather than disagree when in a group. This is a little trick that will get you a long way. Not only will everyone in the group like you, but people outside the group will get a sense that you are a reasonable and collected person. Number four, physical contact is key. For some people, this comes naturally in a conversation. Others plan it as a means to set up a different level of connection. But what is universally true is that if you want to be perceived as a relaxed, reassuring, and non-confrontational partner, you will have to master the art of touching. Okay, things like touching the arm or shoulder of the person that you're talking to can be a very good thing. And there are two sides to this. The first side is this kind of interaction is somewhere above your normal handshake and below a friendly hug. That makes the person feel a bit more special than the other people, even though you don't know each other that well or have just met. Secondly, it increases the chances of getting the result that you want, because people tend to be more compliant after this kind of interaction and find the person doing the touching more friendly and attractive. Bear in mind that you have to use and restrict touching so as not to look like a salesperson. Don't touch everybody you meet and don't do it repeatedly if you feel like you don't get any results the first time. I am guilty of this. I usually tend to touch everybody or just do like a high five with everybody, and I need to stop that. I need to be more selective with my high fives. Number five, the art of eye contact. You've probably been told a thousand times that looking people in the eye is a certified first step to getting what you want. But to bring that effortlessly charming feel into any interactions, your eye contact game needs a bit of work. Because things are not always what you might think. Charming and confident men don't just eyeball people while having a conversation. The real secret here is how to use just the right amount of eye contact to keep the other person listening and interested. The way you do that is alternate between looking in the eyes and looking away and gradually increase the amount of exposure. If you're telling a story to a group of people, it is better to exchange looks with all of them from time to time.
An American family moves into an all-white neighborhood and the mailman knocks on the door and says, "Is Mrs. Myers here?" And she says, "I'm Mrs. Myers." And he went door to door to tell everyone, "Have you seen your new neighbors?" And by that evening, there were about 500 people on the lawn protesting and building a fence around the house.
The eyes are an important source of information and vulnerability, and charming men know that they're one of the best ways to get people attracted to you. Because basically, we're all more likely to do business and build professional and personal relationships with people who can convey honesty and who are polite, modest, agreeable, and kind. And eyes are the best nonverbal way to deliver all that information about you. In the end, don't forget you will never be charming if you don't bring yourself to follow the golden rule. And the golden rule is charm yourself first. Enjoy and turn all of your interactions into familiar, neutral, and open-hearted affairs. And also, do not forget our 5 strategies to becoming more charming, which are: have a good posture, learn to bond with people, be part of a group, physical contact is important, and moderate eye contact is a must. Thank you guys very much for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.